This is SAP Developer News.
The Log4j vulnerability has been all over the news the past few days, and rightfully so, because it combines two concerning factors: the possibility of remote code execution, but also its placement within a library that is so widely used throughout the Java ecosystem. So first of all, if you aren't that familiar with the Log4j situation, then we've placed several links in the video description. There you'll find general high-level news articles, more detailed technical details about Log4j, the vulnerability, and how to begin to mitigate the risk. But within this context, SAP also has released a document, SAP's response to CVE-2021-44228, Apache Log4j. This document lists all SAP products with no known impact, those that have current patches available, and those that don't have patches yet, but often have some configuration workarounds. This document will be continually updated as patches and instructions are released. And on the specific product topic of SAP HANA and XS Advanced, there is a service note with configuration workarounds for XSA. It's note 3130698, also linked in the video description. SAP mentor Jens Gleichmann has authored a blog post that gives a nice overview of Log4j situation, links to several important resources, but also shares his walkthrough of applying note 3130698 to an SAP HANA XSA system. If you're responsible for an SAP HANA on-premise system, then we strongly recommend that you have a look at that blog post and follow along with it as you implement note 3130698.
The December 2021 release of the SAP Cloud Application Programming Model, CAP, is out. Here are just a few of the highlights. There's new support for exists predicates with path expressions, allowing you to cleanly and simply describe complex relationships. There are new annotations for audit logging of personal data access and modifications. CQL now supports the syntax for SQL window functions. And if you're trying out the experimental GraphQL adapter, you can now generate the schema on the command line with a new target for the compile action. Nice. Check out more information on these and many more features in the December 2021 release notes in the CAP documentation.
Two weeks ago, we already talked about exciting new content regarding TypeScript for UI5 development in our Developer News episode. And this week, we are back at it again with the release of a new SAP sample repository on GitHub for full-stack TypeScript app. The TypeScript programming language is often described as JavaScript with syntax for types, and among other things allows for better editor integration, including code assistance, and aims to catch errors early in development with the help of its type system. The sample project demonstrates a possible setup to develop a full-stack application for the SAP Business Technology Platform Cloud Foundry environment using TypeScript in combination with the Cloud Application Programming Model for Node.js and TypeScript for UI5 development. I also published a related blog post to the sample repository to take a closer look at some of the project details, like TypeScript versus regular JavaScript coding, or special requirements to pay attention to when building a TypeScript project and running it on the Cloud Foundry environment. The post also includes many helpful links to learn more about TypeScript for CAP Node.js or for UI5 development. So if you're interested in exploring TypeScript within that context, visit the new full-stack TypeScript app sample repository on GitHub and check out the connected blog post on the SAP community. As always, links to the content are provided in the description of this video.
Here's a couple of ABAP-related blog posts that are definitely worthy of your attention. First, there's a great post from Olga Dolinskaya on the ABAP Platform 2021, which is the foundation for SAP S/4HANA 2021. This post explains what the ABAP Platform 2021 is, what it offers, and details the major investment areas and innovations. It also has links to lots of related material to help you understand what's what. Talking of ABAP Platform 2021, the second post is from Horst Keller on ABAP keyword documentation. This is for application server ABAP 7.56, which is part of ABAP Platform. And this post explains what has been brought to the ABAP documentation in relation to the RESTful application programming model. There are links to both these posts, so check them out.